Hey guys, it's me again. Today I am going to show you what I've been working on. I have been playing around with VCV Rack. If you're not familiar with that, I would definitely suggest you check it out. It is a virtual modular synth VST, soon to be VST. Right now it's just a DAW on its own. So jumping over to that, I've got kind of a lot of stuff going on here. One thing to note that VCV Rack is a CPU hog, so I would recommend kind of recording a little bit of whatever you're doing here in Ableton, and then utilizing it in Ableton from there. After you've got your good solid recording, then you can turn it off. And yeah, anyway. So we are going to go ahead and hit record in Ableton. Okay. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter with ambient music. The BPM doesn't really matter, but I am going to be playing with this later. So I'm going to drop it down to 60 BPM. It's my go-to. So we'll go ahead and hit record again. And here we go. So we've got a few different channels here. It's mostly set on random. Scroll out here so you can check it out. So as you can tell, I got two different note sequencers. One is playing in the key of C major, and the other is playing in the key of G major. Okay, let's jump back over to Ableton, stop that recording, and we've got this beautiful recorded set here. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to delete this guy too. I might come back to it later, but for right now, I want to save my CPU for working in Ableton. So we've got this sample here. Let's give it another listen here. anytime that I record anything on VCV Rack, I throw a limiter on it. I am not trying to blow out my ears or yours, so make sure that you take the appropriate precautions for your ear health. Just to really send it out. Checked out the ample sound pan drum here. It's free. It's so awesome. Really great sounds. Let's go with the double mute. So I'm just gonna let that, since I'm using complete control, I'm gonna just go ahead and throw it into the scale, just so that we don't get any weird tones in. But I'm also gonna pull out the Euclidean sequencer. This creates a sequence mathematically. So it's only hitting once right there. As you can tell, it's only engaging once throughout this sequence. We're going to make that twice as much, actually. Adding multiple events will increase its hit time. And then also you can change the velocity, pitch, duration, and probability here. Adam, what am I doing here? Throw on some reverb and some delay, and you get a really nice thing about this sequencer here is that you've got four different basically you can create four different sequences here with these different step sequencers. I'm gonna make this one 16 as well. We're gonna give it thank you. Let's give it a listen here. So what I just did was took out the Unison MIDI chord pack. It's awesome. I am working on my music theory still, but it's great because you get all of these MIDI files that are individual chords. You can also get extended chords, borrowed and model chords, and then progressions for all of the different keys. Highly recommended. Totally check them out. Really awesome. We're going to throw it onto a pad here and see what this sounds like. Let's turn it down. Give it a go. Thank you. sending it to outer space.
Thank you.
So yeah, there you go. Got a bunch of layers here. It's got some movements. Started out with VCV Rack.